a former FBI and CIA senior official. That is Phil Mudd and Matt Lewis of The Daily Beast. Matt, I want to begin with you because we had something of a conversation on this last night. But how do you reconcile Republicans' claims today that the FBI is biased against President Trump, and of course the Hillary Clinton camp that the FBI was biased against her in the email probe? Both those things can't be true.
Well, look, no, they probably can't be, except I would say two things. One, James Comey had promised Congress that if he found new information, that he would have to reopen the case. He was sort of bound to do it. It was going to come out eventually. And of course, it was very public. This Anthony Weiner's laptop had these, emails on them from Huma Abedin. So that's one explanation. The other would be, frankly, by the time that James Comey in October comes forward and reopens the investigation into Hillary's campaign, I think we all assumed that Donald Trump was going to lose in a landslide, that Hillary Clinton was going to win. Now, I'm not saying, I don't frankly even believe this to be true, but if you're looking for a conspiracy theory, I think you could easily say, look, of course James Comey opened up that investigation. He never thought looking into Hillary was actually going to hurt her. Everybody assumed she was going to win.
Yeah, but that doesn't answer, Matt, what is the fundamental charge here from the president. He is alleging that the entire bureau somehow, its leadership, is biased here. And, of course, some of his supporters go further to a deep state conspiracy extended to the intelligence agencies. It's not just about one person or one day or one revelation of a step in the investigation. They're making a much broader charge here.
Yeah, right. And I think it's unclear. I mean, it's unclear to me whether or not there's some bad apples in senior positions that have done some very questionable things or whether there's something more systemic involved. I will say that today, I think, was a turning point. Up until now, it's been really Donald Trump and Trumpian sycophants who've been trying to delegitimize the FBI. I noticed today a couple examples of people who do not fit that description. One is James Gagliano, who is a CNN law enforcement analyst and a retired FBI agent, who wrote today that the president, along with innumerable others, are fairly alarmed at what may be occurring on the seventh floor executive suites in the FBI headquarters. He writes that changes need to be made at FBI headquarters. Okay. And the other is a CNN legal analyst, Paul Callen, who today really came down and said originally he thought the president's attacks on the FBI were wrong. He's looked into this and, told Poppy Harlow today, boy, there's some really disturbing stuff here.
Okay. You got a couple quotes there, no question. We have the advantage of having a live former FBI and CIA official here, Phil Mudd. What's your view of all this?
This is pretty simple. Let's deal with facts and not with speculation. First of all, the seventh floor of the FBI is not critically involved in the investigation. The FBI director isn't. The deputy FBI director isn't. The special counsel is. He's the former FBI director. So don't tell me the seventh floor of the FBI is tainted. They're not conducting the investigation. Let me give you a couple facts if you want to argue that this is some sort of deep state Democratic conspiracy. Number one, a Trump nominee and appointee, the deputy attorney general, says that this is an appropriate investigation. He nominated a former Republican FBI director nominee, Robert Mueller, to run the investigation. That's two for two senior Republicans who say the investigation is appropriate. Four indictments have come out of this. Two of those have resulted in guilty pleas from people who said, yes, not only did I do wrong, but I lied to the FBI. So we can have all this conversation about conspiracy at the FBI. But I'm going to say, if you think this is a bunch of Democrats conspiring, Republicans run the investigation. The FBI leadership doesn't, including the FBI director nominated by the President of the United States. And number two, there are four indictments, two of which have already resulted in guilty pleas. What do you want?
Matt, how do you respond to that? I mean, the other point I would note, Robert Mueller himself, a lifetime Republican, and when Mueller was chosen, you'll remember, that many Republicans were singing his praises.
Yeah, it's really hard to argue with that. And look, I'll tell you where I kind of come down on this. I think that very clearly President Trump is attempting to delegitimize this institution, and it's perfectly logical and obvious why he would want to do that. It would benefit him, in terms of this investigation looking into him. I do think, however, that the FBI and the Mueller investigation and the Clinton and Trump investigations have aided and abetted Donald Trump in this effort. I think that the FBI comes out of this looking really bad. The problem is there's so many examples. You've got the fact that so many people in this investigation contributed to Hillary Clinton. You've got the fact that McCabe's wife took hundreds of thousands of dollars from a Terry McAuliffe organization.
Listen, our lead in, that was before McCabe was the deputy director, before he was in charge of the investigation.
Makes it worse. Mm-hmm. I think that makes it worse. Why would you promote somebody to be in this position of investigating if you knew their wife gave if it was given like $700,000 by their best friend?
Well, let me ask Phil, it looks really bad. No, you made your point, and I want to make sure Phil gets in before we run out of time. Phil, you served, you're a CIA official, but you served in the FBI as well. I imagine there are people with party affiliations in those buildings, people who vote, people who have donated to campaigns, might even, you know, be guilty of the sin of having a partner with different political views of their own than their own. Phil, in your experience, do folks separate those political leanings or leanings of their partners from the counterterror and legal work they have to do?
I spent 4.5 years with Director Mueller, maybe 2,000 meetings. I never heard the dude make a political comment ever. And let me ask a couple of simple, let's be clear, because I'll tell you where I stand, yes or no questions. If your spouse participates as a politician in an election, should you never be promoted in a federal government institution? Are you kidding me? What are you supposed to say? Sweetie, you cannot participate in the American democratic process. Secondly, if you are an investigator in a political investigation, are you supposed to certify that A, I either support President Trump, or B, I'm neutral? Is that how we do politics in America? I didn't realize that we had to have political certification before we participate in an investigation. And if that's the case, there should never be a congressional investigation because every single one of them is a political partisan. So get out the Senate and get out the House in investigation because they all contributed. Get them out.
Folks, we're going to have to leave it there. But I appreciate both of you taking part in a sane, reasoned conversation about this. Seriously. And we're going to keep it up. Phil Mudd, Matt Lewis, happy holidays to you and your families.
Thank you.